Hey guys, it's Nate, aka TheFutAccountant. Welcome back to the channel. We're going to talk about this loading screen. The market continues to rebound and is going up big time in price. And as well, talk about SBC Fodder because Fodder is crashing on this game. So let's look at this loading screen because we have learned some interesting information about what we see out here right now. And the first thing that we see is 15 items in packs from the EFL, 15 items in packs from the community team of the season this year. So we were worried about this when the voting came out. We only saw 11 cards in the vote. I was wondering what they're going to do. And they're only releasing 30 cards in packs, 15 from each side. Now, let me tell you why this is an L, because last year, the community tots consisted of 20 different players and the EFL team of the season consisted of 21 different players. So we have a 11 card difference between the first week of team of the season. We had 41 cards last year released on that first Tots Friday. This Friday, we're only going to have 30. So what does that mean, right? It means that the red picks, you know, when you have weekend league rewards, your chances for a better card might be a little bit better, or everybody else is going to get the same two or three guys, goalkeepers, probably from the EFL Tots. But also what this means is I'm the most interested in how they start requiring these Tots cards for SBCs, because last year with all those EFL Tots cards and even some of these community cards, they started requiring team of the season for SBCs, which is nothing new, but those team of the season cards, since there were so many of them, they didn't rise that much on the game. So since there's less Tots cards, I'm wondering if in those first couple of weeks we might see, since there's less actual Tots cards on the game, number one, is EA not going to require them because they're not putting as many out? But number two, if they do, could they be more investable and could we see a rise on those cards for their high ratings as people go to do SBCs? Now, that's just speculative, of course, but the real fact is we're only getting 30 cards, and that's still a little bit of an L because I would have loved to see a full 20, maybe even 23 in terms of the cards that would be impacts for community tots, because those are going to be cool cards that a lot of people want to try out and use in their team. So that's kind of a bummer that we learned today. Also, like, that's the smallest update to a loading screen we've ever seen, but it's also nice to have that information from EA to for them to let us know how many cards are going to be in packs. I don't know if they've ever done that before, so that is interesting to say the least. But again, this market is up big right now in FIFA 21. It's crazy how much some of these prices have continued to rise today. We look at a couple examples. I want to show you Mr. Neymar. Not just the gold card, the gold Neymar is up 253,000 coins. He was 220 at his absolute lowest on Sunday and Monday. This 92 Neymar is up 230,000 coins, going from a 1 mil flat on Monday, even lower than that on Sunday. It was like 950 at a point and is now up to 1.235. Crazy rise there. A ton of the meta out of pack specials that are rare. And I really want to focus on these foot birthdays because these cards are rare. They're rare AF, dude, right? This Sterling card was 700K. Saturday, he is 919. Aouar is up over 100,000 coins. Adama is up 125K. Atal is up 100K. Tomori was 430K. He was 500 earlier tonight. Actually, Modric is kind of low right now. He was 245, 250 earlier. Kent is up from being 320K. But these foot birthday cards are very rare. And just like last year, they had that 5-star skill or 5-star weak foot upgrade that makes them very interesting. So I think a lot of these cards do have potential to go even higher as we get towards team of the season. And because those are popular cards that people want to get for their teams. But again, the market as a whole, informs, special promo cards, icons, really have started to boom and take off because people have just realized that the prices that we were seeing were just too cheap and they wanted to get involved and buy some of these cards for their team. Mbabu's 280. He was down at 300K, 200K flat at his absolute lowest. Odegaard is up a decent amount too. I mean, you look through all these promo teams and all you see is just up, up, and up. Now, it looks like Saka is kind of low right now, but this is the beauty of trading in a market like this. When you have a lot of people that are buying and you see prices dipping and there's not big time content that's coming out that's going to make these prices drop. I mean, this Saka card, if this 810 is sitting on the market, I'm low key interested because we have sales at 854, 858, 857. And if I know this is only going higher and could get more rare into the nighttime, 875 earlier today, he sold that. So this would be a card like right now, this is how I would trade in this market. If you're looking at a card that you see has dropped a decent amount in price, that's 100% a great place to look because those fluctuations are going to happen. Now, how many cards do we have like 880? Oh my gosh, dude. Look how many cards we have to 880. This has been on the market. This has been sitting on the market for almost 30 minutes. This Sokka card, man. By the way, this is my first ever time on the PS5 in the menus. And oh my goodness, this thing is lightning fast, bro. I'm slicing through the PS5 menus right now like a hot knife through butter. I absolutely love it. But I'm going to buy this Sokka card because I think I might be able to get upwards of like 880,000 coins tonight for this card. So I'm gonna list it up at 880, and tonight into tomorrow, I'll take, that's nice, like, that's like, what is that? Maybe like 20K profit or something like that. Quick math off the top of the head, that's a W, right? And these cards get rare at nighttime. So that's the kind of trading that you can do in this market right now. Again, I bought this Best for 1.3. This was bought at 400K. I bought this Bamba today at 185,000 coins, and he's probably even higher than 207 right now. I bought both these at 150, sold at 170, and just, there's flips everywhere, right? There are flips everywhere. I bought this Figo at 219, this Lam at 390, and this Dalvin at 170, and a lot of these cards are bouncing back, and it's gonna be a lot of profit to be made right now in this market. So watch for cards that are not up yet too much, like if they're still down, like if this Sun is still 320, well, 323 for this card. If you find like a 310, undercut on the Sun, 325 overnight as well. This is a very rare card that links to a potential team of the season community card. Same thing with this Bergwijn, bro. This guy was like 290 earlier today. He's only 316 right now. You know, I think some of these cards still have room to go up. So it's on a card by card basis. Look at the percentage point rises and say, hey, has this card gone up a lot? Is this card very meta? Could it go up more? And if the answer to any of those questions is yes, then that could be a card that you look to flip as we continue on through this week. So that's going to be like the best place, in my opinion, to trade right now, is scrolling through these special teams, looking down through these cards, and kind of just remembering the prices and knowing, hey, this card was at this point earlier in the day. Right now, this card is here, stuff like that. Varane's 440. You know, I'm if I find one of those at 420, I think he's probably going to go upwards of almost 500,000 coins after rewards. Now, this Kulusevski card is one that has risen a decent amount as well. He's actually 226 right now. I'm pretty sure he was higher than that earlier today. He was in the 230s, yeah, almost 240 range, I thought, a couple times, about 240 almost. So this guy is continuing to rise because a lot of people think Chiesa is going to get into the community team of the season, and that is a very OP card in this game that would link to that Chiesa. Now, here's an example of a card that really hasn't risen much. Sergiño Dest, 234 right now at the moment. He's only up like 10K, which is very interesting. He was actually just 246. So for me, this card was at 248 last night, 232 during the day, and right now he is how much? 234? I'm interested. Your boy is interested. This is the beautiful way you can trade in this game right now, again, because these cards are so rare, too. How many cards to 250 do we have? Look at this, man. We have, like, not even a page to 250. So right now, since it's a little bit later in the evening, I'm going to add this 212 to my transfer targets, check for any bids, and see if there's any open, oh, boom, 6 minutes left on this desk, right? I'm going to try to snag this open bid and then possibly flip it for like 250, 260, you know, in the next day or two. So that, if you're looking for like Thursday flipping investments, I think that's kind of how you can look at the cards and on the market right now. Look for stuff that really hasn't been raised in price that much. And, you know, sink your teeth into it, right? Buy some cards, because I feel like right now this is a buyer's market 100%. This St. Maximin is a very rare item, very hyped up item as well. Still seeing this around like 260. If I can find one of these tonight, maybe on bid for like a 255, or, you know, right there's one at 255. But if I can get something under 260K, I'm feeling really, really good about this card, because this is something that I think could be 300,000 coins again on the weekend. Brand new card, still very hyped up, and only in packs, going out of packs today. So new team of the week today as well. We'll take a second to look at that, because why not? We'll take a look at a prediction, because that, you know, sometimes is good to look at. Who do we have here? We have got Courtois, Greenwood, Leon Bailey, who technically might be in team of the season community as well. I think he's going to get in. A striker Llorente card. Interesting. Flipping. What are you? Is that legit? All right. Anyways, Sigurdsson, Immobile, Parejo, Gunter with a left wing back card. I already mentioned Courtois. And then other than that, it's not looking that insane. Let's always do our due diligence as well. Take a look over at the foot head prediction. We have got Courtois, Immobile, and Angel Correa in this team as well. Another Immobile, another Greenwood, a Diaby, a Ginter center back card, and that's kind of it. So doesn't look like the strongest of team of the weeks. I've seen people rumoring Mbappe to get in, but I'm not really sure if that's going to be legit or not because, you know, Mbappe, maybe EA throws him in, maybe they don't. But I was actually able to snag gold 3 this weekend. I was kind of feeling motivated Sunday night, snagged gold 3 in the weekend league. So I've got some of the best rewards, you know, besides silver 1. I've only gotten gold 3 like twice or three times this year because I always just stop at 11. And I've got some gold 3 rewards coming in this week. So that's going to be fun. Get the 50K packs, of course, for the Team of the Season community. Open them up and see how we do. But again, let's talk about fodder because we've talked about how this market is high. But one part of this market is down bad, and that is SBC fodder. And we're going to look at it right now. You're going to see these prices and be like, wow, this is pretty nuts. So why is fodder down, right? Fodder is down because people were expecting icon SBCs. Shoot, I thought EA was going to do what they always do and try to drain some more coins before this promo starts. And they really haven't done that. It's been a very quiet weekend. It really has been. We haven't had too much in FIFA since Friday with the Prime Icon upgrade. We really haven't had anything since last week. We were always talking about a Prime or Moments pack that could come out or a Moments only SBC, and EA has not dropped that. They really haven't. Could they still this week? I guess yes, but I'm not expecting it, right? I'm really not because I think they would want to allow more people, more time for people to focus on that before Team of the Season actually started. And since we're only 2 days away from TOTS, I really don't know if that is going to be something they end up doing. So 86s are 22,000 coins. These are low. The big ones that I saw today, though, Oblak is 66K, but this is actually up from where he was. Again, just like we've seen the past couple days, on Monday, he was 75,000 coins. Panic sold during the content drop down to 64. Today, he rises back up to about 70,000 coins overnight. Panic sold down to 62K. 62K was this Oblak card. Oblak has not been 62K. Since before Team of the Year. Even during Team of the Year, this guy was 66,000 coins. That was ridiculously low prices for this super high-rated fodder. Some of the 86s and above have gotten dangerously low to a point where I'm now questioning myself, is this going to be lower right now with people that are selling fodder before Team of the Season actually comes out? Is there going to be a low point on this stuff actually before we get to Team of the Season? Because a lot of people are panic selling this because they think we're actually going to hit the lowest of lows. Even, you know, during that first little bit of Team of the Season, they're going to say, hey, I think this is going to be a low point with all the pack supply that comes out, when actually some of the stuff might even be lower right now. It might be lower right now before Team of the Season, before all the safes are opened, just because when Team of the Season actually comes out, you're going to have people that are looking to buy this and invest, because they would then expect after that for it to go up. It's kind of like how people panic sell everything before the actual Team of the Season promo because they think it's going to go down during that time. But in actuality, you have to buy before everybody else starts buying. And I think a lot of people are going to start buying fodder this weekend. So if you see low prices, like if this Oblak is back at 62K after content dropped today on Wednesday, I'm saying club stock it, right? Buy one, throw it in the club. Same thing with the other high rateds. If you see them drop off to crazy, ridiculously low prices where they have not been for literally months on this entire game, since we have had a lot more SBCs come out, this Jordi Alba is how much? 23,000 coins right now for Jordi Alba? Man, I cannot get how over these men, how fast these menus are, bro. I have seen the light because these menus, I'm just sliding through them and I absolutely love it. Anyways, Jordi Alba has not been like 22,000 coins in ages, right? And basically since Team of the Year. And we've seen a huge rise and kind of a huge drop off in the month of March. And I think after Team of the Season, you're going to see this stuff get back to the crazy prices that we saw in March. There are going to be more icon SBCs. That's how EA is going to try to keep us involved. But actually during Team of the Season, you're just going to see smaller fluctuations. So I think it might not be a bad time in the next 2 days if you see more panic selling on this fodder to do a club stock of it on the higher tier specifically, the very higher tier, especially if there are any cards in here that are in the voting for Team of the Season, which looking through this list really quickly for the higher tier cards, I don't think I saw anybody in here. No David Silva, no Henderson, Verratti. None of these cards are in the voting for Team of the Season as far as I'm concerned, or maybe could win. So that's interesting to say the least. But even some of the guys that might get into like Prem Tots out of PAX Golds, like if you think like Salah, where's Salah? Salah might be a decent card that you could sink some coins into. You know, he's 75K as a 90 rated card, so maybe not. But you know, some of the cards that could get a team of the season, maybe like De Bruyne is a 91 rated card. He could go up in, you know, an extra amount if he's out of packs during Prem Tots, not this week, but next week. So that's something to keep an eye on as well. Kind of more of a, not a sweaty way to invest, but, you know, not something that we really, I don't really condone that stuff, not as much, because that's kind of like the very simple play, right? Kane, of course, probably getting a Tots card, 40K for an 88 rated card. Just something to kind of keep your eye on for the next couple of weeks as we get into team of the seasons. But the 84s, 83s are still ridiculously high. Don't touch those. 3.6K per, I mean, that's very expensive. 84s are at 8 to 9K, so they're definitely not low. But keep in mind that this fodder could be dropping a little bit more as we head into the weekend. And that is 100% a situation that I would keep my eyes on. Right there. So 235 for Dest on this bid. I'm going to let that slide because the one on the market right now is 236. So if this gets bought and I can slide in and buy that 236 on the bid of 212, I will definitely try to do that. But again, until we see some big time content come out in this game, it is a flippers paradise right now. Even though there's not a lot of people on this game, the prices are going up because that is a signal of demand, because people are noticing that this stuff is low. There's not much to do. And all signs right now with only 15 cards, team of the season community, looking like it's maybe disappointing. Unless they really juice up these cards, it could be interesting. Now, I still have a lot of thoughts on what's going to happen on Friday. I think some of these team of the season cards this year are going to be really expensive compared to previous years, because this market has a lot of coins and people are just so in love with that first day promo cards this year more than ever, right? More than ever, we see cards not really rising out of packs from a promo because EA, of course, hits us with that next week. And another promo coming out, and that just diverts people's attention to those cards. So I'm really curious to see how this weekend goes, but I really think you're still going to see a rise on this market. So if you see no content today, 100%, I would look to get involved with these out-of-pack specials or icons. Icons, you know, are always a really good Thursday flip. If you see any of those types of cards this week that are still low today, right? New team of the week coming out. If you see stuff, if that's our only content today is the new team of the week, or maybe one of those like prime whatever packs for the league, then I do think you will see, I think you're gonna see a market rise regardless, but try to focus on the stuff that is still valuable meta in-demand players that are on this game that haven't really risen that much yet. You know, guys like Reece James right back is up from 320 to 387. The Neymar that we pointed out, the Varane, road to the final. One thing about those road to the finals is, you know, the fear of the competition potentially not going through has kind of subsided, right? Wow, this Varane is up high, man. 1.45. This guy was 1.3 lows, 1.3 flat earlier yesterday because, again, that Super League talks were going on. Now it's looking like some of the clubs are leaving. So, you know, people's confidence is being restored in that the Champions League would continue to play on. So that card is rebounding up. So look around the market for stuff that hasn't really rebounded up, and that could be a place where you find some deals and you find some good prices that you can then flip after rewards, where you might see more of a market rise. And of course, watch your rare cards in general, as always, because those, they just get rare overnight and you can get some pretty high sales. So that's 100% what I'd be doing on this game right now. That's what I'm doing, right? I'm flipping cards, rare out of pack specials, and it's working pretty great. So definitely a great time to trade. Interesting time for fodder. If you want to get involved, I don't mind it. I really don't. I think you can do a club stock and be well served during team of the season if prices continue to go up, because we're going to get a lot of SBCs during tots, right? We got a lot of SBCs during team of the year. We go back and look at those graphs. They hit that low point like right at the beginning of team of the year, and then whoop, they went up. They went up after that because there was a lot of SBCs that came out. People were crafting as well, and you have to buy some players to finish SBCs when you are crafting. So that's the video for today, boys. If you did enjoy it, smash a thumbs up on it, comment down below if you have any questions, and subscribe if you're new. It's been Nate the Foot Accountant, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace out.